I'm surrounded by garbage. Hey guys, guess what's back? I'm sure you can already tell by the title, but it's empties videos. I actually have more empties than just my regular empties container. I don't know why I don't call it a trash can, because that's basically what it is. I have even more. A Nordstrom bag, almost full. I'm kind of shocked by like how many people are like, do you still do empties videos? You need to do a new one. I don't know why I'm starting to like go off on this topic, but I did not realize how much you guys liked empties videos. I'm sorry it's been forever. I have like tried and true favorites. I have new products. I have stuff I didn't like, stuff I will repurchase, and I will let you know as I go through. And then I will throw away all of this garbage I've been hoarding. I'm a garbage hoarder for YouTube. I say it's for YouTube. It's probably just for me, but I got requests. That's the point. Let's look at my makeup garbage. Okay, let's get started. We're downstairs, so Luna's acting crazy. First up, I am pretty sure there are like 800 of these in here, so we'll just talk about them once. These are the Garnier Micellar Water. This is just like the regular kind. I've tried all the kinds now. I love these things. This is one of the steps in my nighttime skincare that I haven't changed for like probably a year, more than a year. I love this stuff. I keep repurchasing. I have like 5 in my bathroom right now. Here's another favorite. Whoa, this one has a lot in it. This one is not empty. Actually, this one is an old one that I didn't realize I had. It was like hiding in the depths of my cabinet. I need to clean that out so bad. Oh my gosh, it's so embarrassing. It was like a different color. I don't know if like when it gets really old, it changes color, or I got a bad batch or something like that. But I do love this stuff. This one just like turned green. It's the Fake Bake Luxurious Golden Bronze 60 Minute Self Tan Liquid. It's been like my go-to tanning product. I'm continuously trying different things, but I keep going back to this one. I get it at Ulta. It's not that expensive. I like the color that I get, so I keep going back. Next, this is the Soap and Glory Righteous Butter, and this one's kind of special because it has my name on it. That is very smart marketing on their part. That made me really excited, and it shouldn't. I don't, it's the same stuff you can buy in the store, but it made me excited because it has my name on it. It smells amazing. It smells like other Soap and Glory products. I love Soap and Glory, and it's even more accessible now because it's in the drugstore. There's actually like a little bit more in there. I'm gonna use that, but I don't really like jar moisturizers or kind of like jar anything. I feel like it's unsanitary. And also, if you've just put body butter all over, you've got it on your hands, and you try to close this packaging, it's kind of stupid, in my opinion. I feel like everything should have a pump. In my dream world, every product everywhere has a pump. This doesn't have a pump. I'm not repurchasing it, but I do have like other tube Soap and Glory moisturizers. Wow, can we have some makeup in here? Okay, this is a Benefit's Coralista. This is one of my like very first favorite blushes. Benefit was one of the lines that I embraced first when I started liking makeup, mostly because of my mom, because like we just really loved their whole brand aesthetic, like the little retro girls and stuff. And she knew I really liked that, so she would gift me things like on holidays. And this is one of my first ever blush loves. It's hit pan, but it's not all the way done. I would normally finish this completely, but this is from when I cleaned out my makeup room, aka makeup mountain, aka my makeup hoard, and embarrassing. So this is really, really, really old, and I'm getting rid of it. Whoa, I used this. This is one of my big favorites for the past couple of years. It's the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 Foundation. Actually just revisited it because I took a very long break from it, and I've been just like in love with the Maybelline Matte and Poreless. But for the longest time, I was in a very, very committed relationship with this foundation. It's awesome. I would repurchase it, but I think I already did. This one's old. Next up, this is a fresh eye cream. It's the Rose Hydrating Eye Gel Cream. I really, really like this. Like I said, I don't love jars, I love pumps. I don't think I'm going to repurchase this. I wasn't crazy about the fragrance. I don't like rose scented things, but I liked how this felt. I feel like I need to embrace more gel moisturizers. That would probably make me less of like a slimy slug from head to toe, which I don't know how I'll feel about that, but I'm interested. I'm open to it. Oh my gosh, there's stuff in here that's so old. I haven't done a favorites video in forever. Next up here is one of my favorite concealers. This is the number 7 Blemish Control, what is it called? Stay Perfect Blemish Cover in Light Medium. I've talked about this one a whole bunch. I get it from Walgreens and it's a stick concealer, which I love to use on blemishes and the redness around my nose. This one's awesome. It doesn't slide around and I feel like that can happen a lot if you're using stick concealers. This one kind of like goes on like a powder. It's great. It's affordable. Do recommend, will repurchase. Next, how about another jar of body butter? This one was amazing, and for some reason, I made it last for like way too long. Like, it was like years. But that's because I don't really like using jars. Also, this is like fancy. They sent this to me. It's from Kiehl's. It's the Creme de Corps. I don't know. Seriously, only makes noise when I'm filming. It's the soy milk and honey whipped body butter. And this stuff was literally like butter. It was like a jar of butter. It smelled so good. It felt so good. I love this stuff, but I don't like the jar packaging. I have so many moisturizers. I feel like I use moisturizer more than like anyone else on the planet. I like to be like head to toe slimy. Is it just me? Okay, pretend I didn't say that. Next up, we have a blush. This is Milani's Luminoso. I'm obsessed with this blush. Whoa, wait, have you guys heard? Yes, it's broken. That's how much I've used it. It's mostly hit pan, but I think I was getting rid of this just because it's so, so, so old. It's one of my all-time favorite blushes of all time. I feel like everybody loves it. But recently, I heard, as like kind of scandalous, but to spill the tea, Milani switched up the color of everyone's favorite blush. Like, why would you do that? Like, everyone loves it already. Why would you change the color? The new one is much darker. It's much more pigmented, like pink, pink coral color. And this one's more of just like a very pale gold. But I feel like that's why it was so universally flattering. Why you do that to me? Milani, why? Why? Tell me why if you know. You guys might actually know the answer to that. All right, next up we have a shampoo. It's giant, it's larger than my head. It's the Joico Color Endure Violet Shampoo. And I get this from Ulta. I think they have like sales here and there where you can get really big sizes of conditioner and shampoo. It is a purple shampoo, so that's perfect for blondes that want to avoid brassy tones. My hair loves to be like really yellow, if not orange. And so I pretty much always use violet or purple shampoo like every time I wash it. I did repurchase it. I really love it. I would recommend it. Next up, this is another micellar water. It's by Simple, and honestly, I can't remember my thoughts on this. I feel like it wasn't anything better than the Garnier, and for some reason, I just love the Garnier, so I didn't repurchase this. I don't think it was bad. It's another drugstore product, so I love the price, but for whatever reason, I haven't repurchased it, and I have repurchased the Garnier, so I don't know what that means. I'm just telling the truth. Next up, this is a dry shampoo. It's the Elizabeth and James Nirvana Black Dry Shampoo, which is pricey. I got it at Sephora. I got sucked in. I love the fragrance so much. It was a pretty good dry shampoo. I don't remember it like blowing me away as far as its dry shampoo powers, but the scent is pretty much why you buy this. I didn't repurchase it, but I would. The only thing that I didn't really like about it is a strong fragrance and I like to wear perfume. So it's like, you know, so I guess this would be perfect for the person that's already wearing this fragrance and just wants to like extend it to their dirty hair. Next up, we have a brow product. This is by Benefit. It's the Precisely My Brow Pencil, and I have it in shade 2. I loved this. I did not repurchase it though, just because I am always trying so many brow products and I like to, I don't know, I just like to mix it up a whole lot, probably too much, but this is a very good pencil. It's really great because it's a super, super fine tip. It's completely empty. I don't know why I was trying to do that. It's not gonna go up. Nope, 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 nope. Next up, this is from Lush. This is the Happy Hippie Shower Gel. I've talked about this before. I love this fragrance. I would repurchase it, but I never go to Lush for some reason. I feel like I used to be way more interested in Lush than I am now. I don't know, but this is a great scent. I would repurchase it, but I haven't. Next up, we have a dry shampoo. Are you surprised? It's Batiste. This is the Brilliant Blonde color. Is that what you call it? It's got a slight tint, and I guess this would help you with your roots. My roots are kind of part of my hair color at this point. I don't think the blondness of this dry shampoo really helped that much, especially because a lot of dry shampoos have a white cast already. So I don't know, it's okay. Oh, next up we have another Benefit product. This is basically the same story as the Coralista. I just had it for a long time. I have Hit Pan. I have a new Hoola bronzer. I do like the brush, surprisingly. This is a good bronzer. Some people use it as a contour. I feel like my contour is really strong today. Is real strong today. Guys, I'm sorry about this contour. They actually just came out with a Hoola Light, which I like. Maybe they'll come up with a Hoola Dark. Do they need that? I don't know. That Hoola is like pretty dark already. Anyway, this is the Garnier Fructis Damage Eraser Stink Strumpf Reconstructing Butter. It is a leave-in conditioner and I just like do it in the shower. I like it. I don't feel like it did any miracles on my hair, but my hair probably needs miracles that like only God could do at this point. Pretty much same story with this stuff. I've repurchased this like over and over and over again. It's so cheap and I really love the packaging because you just like squirt it out like this and you don't have to deal with a jar when your hands are slippery in the shower. I'm not gonna go off about it again. So this is the Aussie 3-Minute Miracle Strong, and you're supposed to just, you only have to leave it in 3 minutes, which I love because I'm not trying to hang out with stuff in my hair for like 20 minutes. I have things to do. Anyway, next up I have, ew, there's like a long hair on it. This is the Bath & Body Works Aromatherapy Energy Orange Ginger Body Wash and Foam Bath. I got this when my little sister was getting married. My mom like threw this brunch for her and they had like little gift sets for all the bridesmaids, which was so cute. And this was part of mine and I love this. I love ginger scented things and so I very much enjoyed this. Next up, we have another self tanner. This one's amazing. It's also pretty pricey, but I do love it. It's the Vita Liberata 2 to 3 week tan mousse. I don't know about that. It does not last 2 to 3 weeks for me. Actually, I remember on the instructions, they're like, do it like every few days. I'm like, yeah, if you do it every few days, it's gonna last you 2 to 3 weeks, but I don't know. I like this. It has like a different spreadability when you use a mitt. It's like it doesn't dissipate into your skin. It doesn't sink in immediately. You're like able to spread it, which I really like, but it is super pricey. I still kind of think it's worth it though. Next up, I have a body moisturizer that I didn't really like. This is the Kiss My Face Rich Kiss. And it's in the tropical coconut scent. I just wasn't satisfied by this. It actually doesn't feel like I like scraped the bottom of the barrel, which I usually do with moisturizers because like I said, I like to be slimy from head to toe. I don't know, I wouldn't recommend this. I know it's like more like natural product, which I would like to use, especially if I'm like dousing my body in it at least once a day. I feel like that would be nice if it's not like full of chemicals, but this one just, I don't know, maybe my body just likes the chemicals. I don't know. Next up we have the CeraVe AM Facial Moisturizing Lotion. It has SPF 30 in it. I've used this on and off for years and years and years, and I just like it because there's no scent or anything like that, and it has a good SPF. Next up, this is the Bliss Lemon and Sage Soapy Suds Body Wash. I really like this. This smells amazing. I think I actually also have the body butter. I'm in love with this scent. You guys know I love this. I've talked about it in the past. It's my jam. I really like it. Also, I think you can get it at Nordstrom Rack for like a little less than the regular price. Okay, this is a CeraVe PM facial lotion. It is kind of like a cross between a cream and a gel. It's more of a gel, but I really like how light it feels. I probably need like a heavier cream for nighttime, but this one's nice. It's from the drugstore, but the price point is kind of higher. Like, I don't know why, but every time I'm in the drugstore and I get CeraVe, I'm always like, why are you so expensive? I don't know. It works. Okay, next I have a hairspray. This is good old L'Oreal Elnett Granny Hairspray. It's good. It smells weird. It's not my favorite, but I've used like a million cans of it. Okay, and this is the Kiehl's creamy eye treatment with avocado, and it's actually green. We can't tell because it's all the way gone. The only thing I didn't really like about this eye cream is that it kind of didn't spread well. It was super thick. Like if you like a thick eye cream, it just has like a completely unique texture. It's got its own kind of personality. It's a different story completely. If you try to like spread it, it kind of skips. It's kind of strange, but it feels good. I do think it did nice things for my under eyes, but I didn't repurchase it for some reason. There's actually a different Kiehl's eye cream that I wanna try next. Anyway, we're finally done. That was all of the garbage. I can finally throw all of this away. I feel like a new woman. If you made it this far in the video, thank you so much. You are my people. I love you. I know I'm not even doing my little subscribe thing, but like, you are my people, I love you. You were in it for the long haul. That means something to me. I hope all of you guys that wanted a new empties video caught this one. I did it for you. And let me know in the comments, what do you guys wanna see next? I like taking your requests and doing what you guys wanna see. That's what I'm here for. Don't forget to subscribe or check if you're subscribed, because you know. You can also turn on notifications by clicking the bell. That way you'll always know when I upload, and I upload every week. And I love to have you guys back. Give this video a thumbs up if you like empties videos and you want me to keep doing them. I hope you guys are having an awesome day, and thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye everyone. I'm about to burp. Sorry. I know you know, but know that I know that these braids are crazy. That's just where I'm at in my life today.